In this video, I explain introductions of regenerative cycles and one of the matter of achieving the regenerative circuit. That is the three matters for achieve regenerative circuits. But in this video, I explain the one matters, and for another two matters, I make the separate videos. So first matter is the regenerative circuit by using 3x2 DCV. So first we understand the introductions. So by using the regenerative circuit, we can increase the speed of the cylinder. Increase the speed of the cylinder means increase the speed of actuators. Okay. At the cost of reduction in the force developed. Means in a regenerative circuit, we are able to increase the speed of the actuators, but with increasing the speed, the force developed by the actuator is reduced. Now we understand how it's affect. Okay. Means speed will be increased from discharge by area, means capital Q by A, to capital Q by small a. Now what is the meaning of capital Q and small a? Okay, so just I here explain. Speed is denoted as the V and the velocity equation is discharge by area. Okay, so here capital is indicate it is the higher value. Okay, so here capital Q divided by small a means it have higher value, and here the capital Q divided by small a means here we reduce the area, then we are able to increase the speed. Okay, now again focus on these equations. Okay, V means it is the speed or a velocity is equal to discharge by area. Now we have the two options for increasing the velocity, okay, or a speed. Okay, so how we can able to increase? First we are increase the velocity by increasing the discharge. Okay, and second way is to reduce the area, and we are able to increase the velocity. Okay, means discharge is denoted as the Q, area is denoted as A. Okay, so it is the for these equations of the velocity for the simple system. Okay, and this equation, that is a capital Q by small a, is the equation for the regenerative circuits. Okay, but when we increase the speed, at that time the force developed will be reduced from P into capital A to P into small a. Means for a simple system the force is P into capital A, but for the regenerative system the pressure, sorry, force is equal to P into small a. Okay, so here you see that is the equation of the force. Force is equal to pressure into area. Okay, now for increasing the force we have the two options: either we increase the pressure or either we increase the area, because it is in multiplications, then any one parameter is increased. Either we increase the pressure or either we increase the area, where force value is increase. Okay, but here we are increasing the speed by reducing the area. Okay, so when the area is reduced, okay, means this area value is reduced, then what happen? Force is also reduced. Okay, so I hope you can clearly understands how the area is affect to the velocity and the force, where capital Q is equal to pump discharge, means oil coming out from the pump is denoted as the capital Q. Small q is equal to discharge from rod end. Capital A is equal to area of the bore, means it is the inside diameter of the cylinder. Small a is equal to area of the piston rod. We know that in a cylinder, that is a piston connecting rod is there. Okay, so piston is connected with the piston rod, that is the area of the piston, small a. So oil coming out from the rod end port R is made to join with the pump delivery and to flow to the cap end port C. Means oil coming out from the pump and the oil coming out from the rod end point are mixed, then after they supplied to the directional control valves, and from the directional control valve they supplied to the cap end port of the cylinder. That we understand during understanding of the first parts. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP and the other subject of the mechanical engineering. For the OHP, various link is provided in descriptions as well as in a card. Card means on a top right screen of your mobile or laptop you see the I symbols, in which the various playlist is provided, or you also watch the various video by visiting the playlist of my channels. Now we understand the first type of the regenerative circuit, that is a regenerative circuit by using 3x2 DCV. Okay, so here you see this is the diagrams. Okay, so these are the basic component, that is a pump. For run the pump we require the motor, this is the reservoir, pressure relief valve, and here you see it is a 3x2 DCV. How it is a 3x2 DCV? that is a 2 square, means it is a 2 positions, and in every square there is a 3 pot, that is a P pot, A pot and a T pots. Okay. So here this is the P pot, this is A pot and this is the T pots, and it is the manually operated. So this is the symbol for manually operated and this is the symbol of spring return types. Okay. This is the double acting cylinder. This is the cap and pot of the cylinder, that's why here C is written. This is the rod and pot of the cylinders. Okay. Earlier we studied that oil coming out from the rod and pot is mixed with the cap and pot. Sorry, with the oil coming out from the pump. Means oil coming out from the rod and pot is mixed with the oil from the pump. So here you see the oil coming out from the pump is the capital Q, and the oil coming out from the rod and pot is the small Q. Both are mixed here. Then after it is supplied to P pot and A pot, that's why here written as the capital Q plus small Q. Okay. This is the bore diameter, D is mentioned. Here you see that is a rod diameter, D is mentioned. Here velocity is equal to Q by small a is written. Here force is equal to P into A is written. From this side force is the F1 and this side force is the F2. So net force is the F1 minus F2. Why it is a minus? Because the both the force are in opposite directions. That's why it is the F1 minus F2 is written, and F1 minus F2 is equal to net force. Now figure show the regenerative circuit by using 3x2 DCV. A 3x2 DCV is used to operate double acting cylinder. Okay, so here you see this is a double acting cylinders. Okay, for operating the double acting cylinders we use the 3x2 DCV. Okay, generally we know that for operating the double acting cylinder we are required a 4x2 DCV, but in a regenerative circuit we are able to use the 3x2 DCV because we are not required a B pot, because the oil coming out from the rod end pot is directly mixed with the oil coming out from the pump. Okay, so here we avoiding the one pot. So in a first positions of the 3x2 DCV, so in a first position of the 3x DCV, it is the regenerative extension stroke. Why it is the regenerative extension stroke? Because at that extension stroke we are achieving the higher speeds. That's why it is called as the regenerative extension stroke. How we are achieving higher speed? So now we understand. So in a first position you see that the P pot is connected with the both C and R. Okay, so this is the P point, sorry, P pot. Okay, so P pot is connected with the C. Okay, so here you see this is a C pot, and how we say that the P pot is connected with the R pot? Okay, because this oil coming from the rod end pot is supplied here and it is entering a P pot, means P pot is connected with the both pot C and R pots, and in here you see that the this is the tank pot T. Okay, and it is on the closed conditions. Okay, so this symbol is the for the closed position. So here it is written the T is closed. Net force is equal to F1 minus F2, because F1 and F2 is in opposite direction, so we written it is F1 minus F2. Okay, and we know that the force is equal to pressure into area. Okay, so what is the amount of the force developed here? That is a pressure of the oil. Pressure of the oil is in both the side is the P. Okay, but area is changing. So here on a left side of the piston you see that we have the capital A, because we have the capital diameter D. From the D we are able to find out the area, that is a pi by 4 into capital D square. So here directly area is written. Okay, now what is the value of F2? So for the F2 side, means on the right side of the piston, the force is F2. Okay, so force F2 is equal to pressure into area. Okay, but here that is a bore diameter D, and the rod inside the bore, that is a rod is there. Okay, so we need to subtract the area of the rod. Okay, so pressure is the P in the bracket capital A minus small a. Capital A means area of the bore, and the, from the area of the bore we need to subtract the area of the rod. Okay, because the oil is on the area of the capital D minus small d. Okay, that's why here the in the bracket capital A minus small a is written. Now we open this last bracket. Okay, so it is a here P into A minus, so here minus is written. We open this bracket, that is a P into A, and minus n minus, that is a P into small a. Okay, so this is minus and minus is plus. Here I written the minus, but here it is a plus signs. Okay, so you consider it is a plus sign. Okay, so here it is a plus signs. So this P into capital A minus P into capital A is cancelled, because it is one time plus and one time minus. Okay, and the remaining part is the plus P into small a during the regenerative extension strokes. Okay, suppose it is a simple extensive stroke, then what amount of the force is in produce? That is a force produced during the simple extension stroke is the P into capital A. Okay, But during the regenerative extension stroke, we are achieve the P into small a. P into small means area is reduced and the force is reduced, and the force is reduced means the speed is increased. Now, due to this net force, DSE is extend. Extend means the piston is moved from left to right sides. Velocity of the piston. So, for the velocity of the piston, we are able to return the three equations. Okay. So, here you see that is the left side of the piston, it has some different discharge. On the right side of the piston, that is a different discharge. And with the piston rod is connected. Okay. So, from these three prospects, we are able to return the three definitions. Okay. So, on the left side of the piston, what is the discharge? Discharge is the Q plus small q. Okay. And what is the area on the left side? That is a capital A. Okay. So, this definition is written. And this middle equation, that is a capital Q upon small a, is written from the piston rod concepts. Okay. So, what is the force acting, or what is the discharge on this piston rod? That is the capital Q. Okay. Because here the small q is there, but on the piston rod, only the Q quantity of the discharge is acting. Okay. And the area of the rod is the small a. Equal to small q upon capital A minus small a means, this equation is written by considering the discharge and the area of the right side of the piston. So, discharge on the right side of the piston is the small q. Here you see it is a small q is written. What is the area? Area is the capital A minus small a. Okay. So, by this way, we are achieving the three different equations of the, or a three different equations of the velocity of pistons. Now, in second position of the 3/2 valve. Second position means this directional control valve is connected with these positions. Okay. At that time, what happened? So, this is the normal retraction strokes. Normal retraction means it is we achieve with the normal velocity, not less, not more velocity. So, oil flow from pump to R port. Okay. Means oil coming out from this pump is directly supplied to the rod end port. How it is possible? Because the P port is closed. Here you see in the second position, this P port is closed, and when this P port is closed, suppose this P port here we put the close symbol, okay, then oil have the only one option to go to the rod end ports, okay, and the oil from the pump to the rod end port and the cap end port to the tank. Here you see that the cap end port is connected with this here A port, and the A port is connected with the T port, okay, and the from the T port oil is supplied to the reservoirs, and here you see this P port is the close conditions. During the stroke, the force F is equal to pressure into capital A minus small a during the retractions. Due to the force, DSE is retract. Means on a right side we supplied the oil, okay, with the pressure of the P, and the right side what is the area? That is a capital A minus small a. So it is called as the normal retraction strokes. And due to this force F is equal to P into capital A minus small a. Due to this force, the double acting cylinder is retract. Retract means it is moved from right to left sides. And the velocity of the piston is equal to, velocity of the piston is denoted as the V, and V is equal to capital Q divided by small a minus capital A. Because during retraction, we are supplying the capital Q quantity of the oil. Okay. So, we draw the second image, then the parameter is changing. Okay. So, we supply the capital Q, because the capital Q is the quantity of the oil coming out from the pump. It is directly supplied to the rod end ports. Okay. That's why here the capital Q is written, and the area is the capital A minus small a, and it is the normal retraction or during the retraction stroke. So, thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video and don't forget to subscribe my channels for watching the more video and share with your friend.